Every so often, you come across a figure, a toy that just blows your mind. And given I've probably reviewed in the close to maybe 4,000 odd figures in my time, if not more, across multiple channels, oh my goodness, this figure is incredible. Let me just start by saying that. This is the Heat Boys Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Leonardo. I will show you more of this figure in just a second. This figure comes with an instruction booklet, and it is absolutely critical. It is really important you read this if you do foray into this. It is basically the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles as if they were inside a giant kind of Gundam-like mech, and we'll get to that in a minute. So, look, just a quick scanning overview because there's too much to go into within this toy. We would be here all night. Lots and lots of accessories you can see on screen there, from shuriken to swords to pistols to really cool blasters and a shield. There's all sorts of components and parts and pieces to allow you to add separate parts to it, clip them onto the figure, clips for each part to allow the swords to clip on, multiple positions. You've got a shield, for example, that can detach and have multiple different views. We'll get a look at that. There's an electronics function to light up the lights. There's a backpack which has a removable cockpit. Yes, a cockpit. We'll get to that. There's a stand that comes with a working sewer. We'll get to that. We've got these poles to provide stands for the figure. And a little bit of a pre-order bonus is you can actually make a kind of build-a-figure of the turtles and a little turtle van. I mean, this is just insane. Heat Boys is a Chinese company, been around not that long, but my goodness, these guys have just blown my mind. So you do need a couple of batteries if you want to add this into the figure. I never put batteries in figures these days because they just end up. You never turn them on, and like Hot Toys, you gotta unscrew them and so forth to get in. But in this case, yeah, it is two batteries that'll go inside, and all it does is light up two very small eyes on Leonardo. But yes, lots of stuff going on here. As you can see, there's the lights, constant light mode or breathing light mode. Oh my goodness, lots of articulation. You can see all the articulation points here, and it's kind of important because, again, we could be here all day talking about this, but. Obviously, what it's saying is there's flaps on the front. It's always about the flaps. Lift up those flaps, and you can extend the ab crunch down on the figure even more. And you can see side to side, the head moves up and down. So again, I'm saving some time here to show you all this stuff. Arms, full articulation. The figure is die-cast, so literally everything moves, including the fingers. So this is why I'm not covering every little bit of detail, because we would be here all night. Knees bend, double joints at the knees, toes bend. We got everything going on here. This little cockpit, I'll show you at the back, but a little tiny mini Leo sits in a cockpit and rotates around to power this mech. It's insane. Lots of different panels to pop off, which gives you 4 mm plug holes, which then you can plug in all of these swords and parts and pieces like the shield that we'll talk about and show you in a second. So you can have, for example, a mini shield that's got two swords poking out either side, or you can have a shield which is basically firing shurikens. You can have the shield broken down to be kind of, I guess, like a camo skirt piece that you would get on like an ARC trooper in Star Wars. You can make them into shoulder pads. It's just nuts. It goes on, and it's incredibly crazy. The figure can rest onto the stand here just with a little butt flap. He's got a little piece there that you pop off the butt and you can pop in that stand. And there's the little minivan, which you will get with all the other figures eventually. You're getting parts and pieces with each one. A build-a-figure for effectively a Hot Toy. So, yes, very, very cool place. Oh my goodness, just incredible. Just incredible. So that's what comes, this huge instruction manual. It's very tiny and hard to read. Comes in a little gorgeous Leonardo envelope there too. Box is pretty outstanding as well. I'll try and give you a little side panel. It's done in a kind of smoky gray color. This is basically Hot Toys quality stuff here, but again, it's a Ninja Turtles mech or a Ninja Turtles Gundam kind of figure essentially. It's just nuts what it can do. You name it, all the poses, all the articulation, it has it. I'm not going to waste too much time going over every single little bit here, but loads of accessories, Loads of parts, loads of poses. Oh my goodness, just outstanding. So, nothing else to really show you in the box. Leonardo is the name on the bottom of the box. And then the other side, just to be complete on the box, just another shot. I mean, look at that thing. Wow. Just wow. Had this for a little while, but I've been so backed up with reviews, it's been incredibly difficult to even open this huge box and get into that. But let us dig on, because you just have to see this thing. So before we get into him, I want to talk about the stand very quickly, because there's so many parts and pieces this comes with. So not only to get a classic kind of TMNT Turtles display, but if you pop this open, which I'm probably not, there you go. You get all the little parts and pieces inside, the little Leo minivan we talked about, the different kind of butt plug stand bits that you can go into the back, and that allows you to then, as I say, plug this into the back near the butt to kind of hold the figure up. So you've got one at an angle here, I've got the straight one on there. The shurikens inside here, there's all the little plug-in parts and pieces and things that go in the figure. We'll talk about all this. And if you were to have the batteries inserted inside the head, what you would get here is you'd use this little pizza part, almost this little almost quarter pizza part, and just tap that on the head, and the lights would come on. And again, you get two different modes. Tap a second time, and I think you get the kind of pulsing mode. So just incredible to think about the figure and then also think about the stand and then put it all together to give you this incredible display is just forward thinking and engineering. Like I just have not seen it in a long, long time. So the stand there, this is what we're talking about, this little butt part here that plugs in. You just the figure just slots onto the back, and that can pose. It's more designed for much more dynamic poses. But you also have a taller pole there, which you can have, which allows you to then either have this or the other stand overall. But let us get into this figure. Had to get all that out of the way because there's so much to cover, and we haven't even started the figure yet. Let me zoom in on this and just go around the figure and just show you some incredible details. So it is a die-cast figure, and you're talking 9 inches. Or about 23 centimeters tall. Now the mouth is articulated too, so you can have that close up. But all across the figure, you can see the little transfers and details on the figure. Let me see if I can zoom right in here. We'll just get some real super close stuff. It's just nuts. Caution fire or something. The Leonardo symbol, you know, it's even got the old comic style on there. But again, it's designed to be a mech robot. Lots of different little transfers and details. It is so microscopic. Caution, extreme heat, I think that says there. TMNT01. And there's different designs for the other characters that are coming. They've barely been shown, some of them in finalized parts. And I took a bit of a gamble on this. I didn't really know. I just saw the pictures and thought, I have to have this. I have to have this, and boy, oh boy, am I glad that I did. It is something else. Leonardo, again, die-cast metal. It is not a plastic figure. It is a full-on die-cast figure. So each of the hands, kind of like some Transformers, has a little nodule on it that you can then clip on weapons, which holds it on even better, and then the fingers go around the weapon too, so it's exceptionally well designed. Everything is everything, sorry, I should say, not customizable, but posable. It's really posable, which is again for something that is both die cast and all this different kind of parts and pieces. Oh my goodness, the weapons! Let's get a look at the weapons because they're just outstanding. Let's bring this bad boy down here and we'll get a look off the stand. And my goodness, what weapons he comes with! So, as you can probably see there, we've got a 01 TMNT on the shoulder there, and again that carries across the weapons there too. Kind of reminds me of the Aliens. LV-426, second movie, kind of gut weapons and guns. It just,
It's nuts. And I think some features like that, the little pump action, yep, the little pump action works. These little canisters of ooze, I guess, there, you can take them out if you want. Oh my goodness. And there's the point I was talking about, the little, if you unclip the weapon on the inside, this little part there clips into the weapon there, and you get an extra kind of way to basically grip onto the figure. There we go, and that kind of clips on. So you don't really need to put the finger around there, but it does help, and it works. And it's quite solid. I've not got it in fully there. The blades on the figure, I mean, oh my goodness. Again, die cast metal, so it looks even more detailed, really solid and heavy. We have on the other side of the figure here, as I kind of go around, again, you've got side swords here too. Oh my God, it's just there's so much going on in this figure. All the little details, all the little cautions, all the joints on the figure. It's just wild. The coloring's beautiful. It is absolutely crazy. Even the kind of side bandana that he's got there has a little caution on it too. This is not removable at the back here, but you can kind of just obviously, as I said, pose the head around and do whatever you want with that. It is just nuts. And again, you can open the mouth if you wanted to get some kind of pose. And of course, as I said, lights, but I don't have the particular batteries that it required to hand. Just incredible. Let us flip around here. In fact, let's flip around and get a look at this weapon down here, because that was a standout feature too. Another smaller weapon here that plugs into the side. Just again, so cool, so awesome. It's just an amazing, amazing figure. So as you can see on the back, let me position the camera there. We have the kind of shell. Here's in a half shell. So if we move these just a little bit out of the way, like actually I can't because the way I've positioned this, but you can see underneath here there's that little butt part there that you plug in the stand to. You can, if you're not using it, then move this jet thruster down, and that kind of covers that up at the back. But every part on this backpack is basically comes apart. It's just crazy. It can move, it's on hinges. But if we pop this up, and everything is a little brand new, so bear with me. There we go. It's a little bit hard to see there, but if I pop that up, you see inside there. You see that? The little, let me zoom in there for you. So there's all sorts of details and greeblies inside the figure machinery parts. Again, it's supposed to be a gigantic mech, but as we turn this little canister around, maybe it's the other way. There we go. You can just about see there's a tiny little Leo sitting in a chair, a little see-through plastic Leo. Controlling the figure. Let me see if I can get the light right on. And there you go. So, I mean, just that's nuts. That's nuts. That's nutty amount of detail for a figure. But again, just great little thoughts. And I mean, again, this is inside the back of the shell. Who's really looking? But I mean, that just makes it makes it something special. And this truly is one of the most special figures I have seen in a long. Long, 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 long time. It is just, it's unreal. I just can't stop seeing it. There we go, and that clips back in. The whole shell can come apart in different ways and angle out and pose. Just as I was saying, the shield does too, because it can get split into three, as I showed you in some of the images. Again, we could be here all night showing you the different views of the figure. But you can either have this shield split apart. Again, these can be shoulder pads and/or side kind of armor at the thighs, and it's up to you what you want to do with it, but it's just nuts. Again, you can see if we zoom in just a little bit more to some of the joints inside the figure, you've got very clear metallic joints in there, solid die cast metal, or so it spins around, moves. You got to watch sometimes, obviously, that the paint doesn't scratch if you're moving the figure, but everything has a kind of flap to allow you to adjust and get a better pose. So as you move around, you can then adjust the armor out and up. The same for that elbow, as you can see there, the joins that move, twists at the biceps. It's insane. You've got every point of articulation you could probably need, and individual figures, fingers, I should say. So, you know, you want a thumbs up, you got a thumbs up. You want something else, you're getting something else. There's all sorts of kind of just displays here. The swords, as I mentioned, there's parts everywhere here. You can have these other little smaller swords that can clip out. And again, die-cast metal, so really heavy. Beautifully done. There are photos of this online. I would definitely recommend you take a look at them, because there's like 40 different photographs officially. It's just, there's an intense amount of detail going on here. And the poses you can get with this guy, with weapons, without weapons, with swords, with katanas, with shield, on the shoulder pads, without, flying through the air. It's just an incredible, incredible figure. It's got to be my figure of the year so far. It's really just a standout. Loads of detail, loads of weaponry, parts and pieces, thought and attention gone into different aspects of this figure. Well made. Instructions kind of suck a little because it's very, very small and hard to read, but that's pretty much the same with all Asian kind of builds and figures to keep costs down. Very small kind of manuals. But, yeah, I mean, every little, connector joint at the knees, that one will move to allow you to then pose the figure if you want and swivel that thigh around. It will give you more kind of space, or you can clip it in, as I've done there. The chest, as I mentioned, to get that ab crunch, you can lift that, crunch more. We're already at 17 minutes, and we've barely covered much on this figure, but it's just incredible. So definitely check it out. At least have a look at it and enjoy the toyetic value this has came to fruition for designers, because it's official, it's licensed. It's incredible. The Heat Boys Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Leonardo mech is outstanding, and I cannot wait for the others. As soon as I got this and really got out of the box, the others were pre-ordered. It's that good. Let us know what you think. We'll see you soon. Cheers.